Gå inn i din tid under en blodig storm, vid deg til strid. Kanskje du spør i angst, udekket åpen, hva skal jeg kjempe med, hva mitt våpen? Her ditt vern mot vold, her ditt sverd, troen på livet vårt, menneskets verd. For all vår fremtids skyld, søk det og dyrk det, dø om du må, men øk det og styrk det. Skal tape. Da synker våknene maktesløst ned. Skaper vi menneskeverd, skaper vi fred. Den som med høyre arm bærer en byrde, dyr og
my search patrol, hunting Charlie down. It was in the jungle wars of 65. My weapon jammed and I got stuck way out and all alone. And I could hear the enemy moving in close outside. Just then I heard a twig snap and I grabbed my empty gun. And I dug in scared while I counted down my fate. And then a big marine, a giant with a pair of friendly eyes, appeared there at my shoulder and said, "Wait." When he came in close beside me, he said, "Don't worry, son, I'm here. If Charlie wants to tangle now, he'll have to die." I said, "Well, thanks a lot." I told him my name and asked him his. And he said, "The boys just call me Camouflage." Through the brush and all around our ears. It was then I saw this big marine light a fire in his eye. And it was strange, but suddenly I forgot my fear. Side by side we took our battle stance, and I wondered how the bullets missed this man. 'Cause they seemed to go right through him, just as if he wasn't there. And the morning we both took a chance and ran. And it was near the riverbank when the ambush came on top of us. And I thought it was the end and we were had. Then a bullet with my name on it through a bush, and that big marine, he just swatted with his hand, just like it was a fly. Weird about him, 'cause when I turned around, he was pulling a big palm tree right up out of the ground and swatting those Charlies with it from here to Kingdom Come. When he led me out of danger, I saw my camp and waved goodbye. He just winked at me from the jungle and then was gone. And when I got back to my HQ, I told him about my night and the battle I'd spent with a big marine named Camouflage. When I said his name, a soldier gulped and a medic took my arm and led me to a green tent on the right. He said, "You may be telling true, boy, but this here is Camouflage. And he's been right here since he passed away last night. In fact, he's been here all week long." But before he went, he said, "Semper Fi," and said his only wish was to save a young marine caught in a barrage. "So here, take his dog tag, son. I know he wants you to have it now." And we both said a prayer for a big marine named Camouflage. Whoa, Camouflage, things are never quite the way they seem. This was an awfully big marine. So next time you're in a jungle fight and you feel a presence near, or hear a voice that in your mind will lie, just be thankful that you're not alone and you've got some company from a big marine boys call Camouflage.
Houston.
How you doing, bro?
Where you been?
Where you going? Then he takes your hand in some strange California handshake and breaks the bone.
Benny pointed at a hi-fi shop. He said, "Hey man, Look at all the stuff they got. How'd you make a have out of a have not?
Who needs information
when you're working underground? Just give me confirmation. We could win a million pounds. Benny climbed up on a footbridge,
and he teetered on the parapet. He said, can you see the whites of her headlights?
Are they coming yet? Who needs information? This high off the ground. Just give me confirmation. We could win a million pounds. Who needs information when you're living in constant fear? Just give me confirmation. Yeah.
Kids. Hi there, and welcome to the Capital Help a London Child Quidsworth, featuring a few jolly jingles, a hi from the guys, and a handful of our bouncier adverts. But first, here's our morning star.
Hello, this is Graham Dean, direct from The Breakfast Show. Well, almost direct. I tell a lie to go into the canteen first. Now, they've got me here to wish you a happy Easter. So, happy Easter.
Sightseeing, Spain is the sand, siesta for me. advert we always enjoy having in our progs. Great Scott!
Wow, that's
who's this ill-fitting creature?
Hello, this is Roger Scott. Just dropped in to wish you a happy Easter and to thank you for buying this bit of rubbish. Hang on to it. In 50 years' time, it could be worth as much as a pound.
Well, this is 194. How are you?
Great.
Vogue has the prices that are the very nicest. Vogue has a selection that everyone adores. Come to Vogue Interiors, a furniture superior. Vogue cash and carry, furniture yours.
Hello, this, I am proud to say, is Michael Aspel, and I simply want to wish you happy Easter, good luck, good health, and above all, goodbye.
Superior interiors from
And now, the Capital Quality Department brings you Classic Time.
Hello, this is Peter James. I'd like to lend a little bit of decorum to these proceedings and wish you all a very happy Easter. And don't forget Beethoven, Brahms and all that lot do too.
Peter James on 194.
Yeah!
Isn't it good to know?
Capital.
And now, friends.
Commercial time.
194.
Richard's shops are filled with all the pretty things, soft and lovely pretty things to wear. Hey there, pretty things, make the world a prettier place. Come pretty up, come buy your clothes at Richard's shops.
Altogether. That was for those of you who have never heard it in stereo before. And don't forget, Capital is stereo 24 hours a day. And if you'd like it that way...
Just cram your finger in the dial.
Just cram your finger in the dial.
Just cram finger in the dial.
And tune to 95.8, where you'll hear...
Little Nicky Hall,
Little Nicky Hall.
Easter, a time when young men's thoughts turn to eggs. Anyway, this is Nicky Horn, hoping that you and your mother have a very happy Easter. Good yontif.
Hello, this is Dave Cash wishing you a very Merry Easter.
Isn't it good to know, Capital?
The station that fits snugly into your ear.
And now, Capital's own Fuzzy Bear presents a joke.
Hey, my brother's so bow-legged, when he stands around the house, he stands around the house.
That's terrible.
No, it's Capital.
Oh,
the Muppetation Station. Yeah.
I used to think the world was flat, rarely threw my hat into the crowd. I felt I had used up my quota of yearning. Used to looking on the children at night, in the glow of their dun-dug light, and frighten myself with the thought of my little ones burning. But oh, the tide is turning. Satellite buzzing through the endless night, exclusive to moonshots and world title fights. Jesus Christ, imagine what it must be earning. Who is the strongest? Who is the best? Who holds the aces, the east or the west? This is the crap children are learning.
Oh,
battle is won. But on Saturday night, all those kids in the sun rest in technology's sword in the hands of the warlords.
If you don't have any art, you're pretty much lost.
I wanted to tell everybody, I think you should get out there and do it too. I even changed one of my songs to fit the occasion. It goes, vaccine, 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 vaccine. I'm begging of you, please don't hesitate. Vaccine, 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 vaccine. 'Cause once you're dead, then that's a bit too late.